Soviet and later Russian cosmonauts have observed interesting, unusual, and often inexplicable phenomena while in space. Some of them have talked about their experiences, although doing so was not encouraged by their space program, nor is it still encouraged today. Now, a cosmonaut is a person trained by a human spaceflight program to command, pilot, or serve as a crew member of a spacecraft. Cosmonauts are professional space travelers. Cosmonaut Vladimir Ljachov once remarked about a very unusual phenomenon he observed from his spaceship looking down on Earth. Two gigantic waves ascended from the waters of the Indian Ocean and crashed onto each other. The mass of water resulting from the crash seemed to be a giant mountain that had vanished in an instant. The information about this was published in a very popular Soviet magazine, Technika Molodezhi, issue 3, 1980. Some of the observations and revelations from Soviet and Russian cosmonauts that I'll tell you about come directly from that very unusual and very bold magazine for the Soviet times. Some other sources will be mentioned as well. Now, cosmonaut Vladimir Kovalenok reported a very similar water pillar of over 100 kilometers in height in the Timor Sea near Australia. Cosmonaut and scientist Evgeny Khrunov remarked back in 1979 in an article published also in Technika Molodezhi that UFOs cannot be denied, as thousands of people have observed them. Properties of unidentified objects simply astound the imagination. By the way, he was also as outspoken in another interview a year later. Now, all these conversations took place in pre-perestroika times, so Khrunov could not speak freely at the time. Cosmonaut Alexei Gubarev went a step further. He admitted that he believed in aliens. Interestingly enough, he mentioned the information that the Americans had at their disposal, information that confirmed his belief. Cosmonaut Valery Rozhdestvensky, who doesn't believe in the presence of extraterrestrial civilization anywhere in the close vicinity to us, at the same time revealed knowledge about secret rumors or information those outside of the special circles, meaning the Soviet space program and the Soviet military, could not know. In the article in Technika Molodezhi, issue 10, 1980, he stated that he did not believe that a small green man actually knocked on the porthole of a Soyuz spaceship. Apparently somebody else did believe this. Russian UFO researchers managed to collect more information about cosmonauts and strange phenomena. An article published in Spectre newspaper, issue 8, 1992 in Leningrad, just after the end of the Soviet Union, listed several incidents. In 1976, cosmonaut Vladimir Kubasov told a reporter that he and others had numerous facts that prove existence of UFOs. By the way, this was the year of the famous Tehran UFO incident in Iran, the year of 1976. And in 1978, Vladimir Kovalenok observed a strange object on August 15 from the Salyut 6 space station. The object approached and distanced itself repeatedly. Cosmonauts Valery Rumin and Leonid Popov, while aboard the same station in 1980, they stayed from June 14 to June 15. They had observed a school of white glowing dots that took off in the area of Moscow and flew into space above their space station. This they reported to the ground control. An interesting sighting took place on September 2, 1978. Soviet cosmonauts Vladimir Kovalenok and Alexander Ivanchenkov observed the shadow of Salyut 6 orbital station over the clouds. The shadow had very strange orange-reddish color. What's more amazing, it changed its size. Earlier that year, on August 25, both cosmonauts observed iridescent clouds, green, purple, reddish, blue, and even violet. Other Soviet cosmonauts, such as Vitaly Sevastyanov, Pyotr Klimuk, had observed and reported silvery clouds, very unusual, very strange clouds. The origin of the clouds remains unexplained. Sevastyanov was mesmerized by their dull, occasionally pearly white, cold glitter. The structure of such clouds was either very thin or bright on the edges of the pitch dark sky, or porous, resembling a swan's wing. These clouds are said to be a magic spectacle. Russian astronomer Vitold Cesarsky first reported them in 1885. The clouds are the highest in the Earth's atmosphere, located at the altitude of 70 to 90 kilometers. They consist of diffused particles, but its nature is still unclear. Colonel Yuri Nazarov, former deputy commander of the Soviet Space Mission Control Center, recalled that on August 29, 1978, cosmonauts Kovalenok and Ivanchenkov and the newly arrived cosmonaut Valery Bykovsky and the East German cosmonaut Zygmunt Jan had observed an unidentified large-sized spherical object that flew around Salyut 6. After the cosmonauts returned to Earth, the renowned Soviet UFO researcher Vladimir Azhaja approached Bykovsky to get some explanations, but the cosmonauts only admitted that they did not observe something inexplicable from aboard the Salyut. And the source is Azhaja's booklet, Meet the UFOs, published in 1990. Cosmonaut Georgi Grechko reported seeing a strange being of gigantic dimensions over Mongolia. Georgi Grechko and Yuri Romanenko had also reported to the Soviet Space Mission Control Center, or Center, that while in their orbital station over the Falkland Islands, they had actually observed huge letters. The photograph they took was delivered to Earth by visiting cosmonauts Zhanibekov and Makarov. Cosmonaut Vladislav Volkov, who perished in 1971, recalled the inexplicable noises he had heard in space, in his headset intercom. Sounds of dogs barking and later babies crying. The Earth was below and the cosmonaut was in orbit, yet he heard those strange noises. To his death, Volkov was not able to explain what he felt at the time. Cosmonauts Yuri Gagarin and Alexei Leonov heard music that the former explained as being not of this Earth. Not everything could be explained by sensory deprivation, nor did everyone involved attempt to seek explanations. The source for this information is NLO magazine, 1999. Cosmonaut Yuri Malyshev said that when it comes to UFOs, no one in the world probably can say what they are. It is impossible to refute similar phenomena, for there were thousands or tens of thousands of people who have witnessed UFOs. But the physical nature of the phenomenon remains indeterminate. Again, this is from Technika Молодежи, issue 11, 1981. Earlier that year, cosmonaut Vladimir Aksionov was more cautious. He said that the cosmonauts often observe peculiar light phenomena of as yet inexplicable nature. The contemporary stage of research of the phenomena is similar to the early establishment of such sciences as zoology and botany, when the naturalist simply described unknown species of animals and plants. Now, he revealed it also to Technika Молодежи in 1981, issue 1. Now, in the year of 1982, on July 12, Soviet cosmonauts Georgi Береговой and Valentin Lebedev were able to observe an unusual drop-shaped object on the monitor screen of the Salyut 7. This object flew, ascending between the orbital station and the Progressor 14 craft. The object, at the distance of 200 meters, could have been the size of a spaceship. the cosmonauts reporting their sighting to the center. This information comes from the book authored by German Kolchin, former Soviet colonel and UFO phenomenon researcher. The author also recalls speaking with cosmonaut Pyotr Klimuk in April of 1989, and the cosmonaut confirmed that he does not refute existence of UFOs. The source is phenomenon Analovsglad iz Rossii, or USO phenomenon, the view from Russia. This was Kolchin's book published in St. Petersburg, Russia in 1994. An interesting interview was published in Sputnik magazine. The subject of the article was perception of UFOs by cosmonauts and astronauts. It contains stories told by 10 Soviet and American space explorers. Only one did not refute the possibility of UFOs coming to our galaxy. Yevgeny Khrunov actually mentioned that it is not possible to deny their, meaning UFOs, existence, presence in our galaxy. Thousands of people have observed them. Maybe they're optical illusions, but some of their characteristics, for instance, the change of their flight course at 90 degrees, just boggle imagination. Cosmonaut Gennady Strykalov mentioned that he saw strange phenomena several times, but is hesitant to classify it as UFOs. But his colleagues did see flying saucers, and he envies them. That's what he mentioned. Strykalov did not provide details about their sightings. He described the phenomenon he observed in 1990, on September 28, during his stay on the space station Mir. It was a sphere over Newfoundland at the altitude of 20 to 30 kilometers. The source for his statements is Rabochaya Tribuna newspaper, October 16, 1990 issue. The atmosphere was clear and visibility perfect. The sphere was beautiful and changed colors. It remained visible for 10 seconds and vanished instantly. Strykalov remembers that it had a perfect shape. He reported the incident to the Mission Control Center, but did not classify it as a UFO. Cosmonauts must be cautious, he said. Cosmonaut Gennady Monakov was with Strykalov aboard the Mir station and observed the same phenomenon. Now I want to talk about a very interesting case of pilot cosmonaut Afanasyev and UFOs. Very, very interesting and complicated case. In 2004, Russian cosmonaut Viktor Afanasyev was featured in the program aired by Russian REN-TV. The title of the program was «Земля под прицелом НЛО» – «UFOs target Earth». Interviewed by Western journalists, the cosmonaut revealed that he flew the Soyuz 30 spacecraft to dock with the Soyuz Salyut 6 orbital station. But while en route, something strange happened. Cosmonaut Afanasyev saw an unidentified object turn toward his craft and begin tailing it through space. This is what happened according to the translation of his statements for the Sightings TV show about astronauts, cosmonauts and their sightings. The date of the show airing is unknown. The object followed the spacecraft during half of their orbit. The cosmonauts observed it on the light side, and when they entered the shadow side, it disappeared completely. It was an engineering structure made from some type of metal, approximately 40 meters long with inner hulls. The object was so narrow in one part and wider in another, and inside there were openings. Some places had projections like small wings. The object stayed very close to the spacecraft. The cosmonauts photographed it, and their photos showed it to be 23 to 28 meters away. In addition to photographing the UFO, Afanasyev continually reported back to Mission Control about the craft size, its shape, and position. When the cosmonaut returned to Earth, he was debriefed and ordered never to reveal what he knew, and had his cameras and film confiscated. Those photos and his voice transmissions from space have never been released. The other crew members did not come forth. It is only with the demise of the Soviet Union that Afanasyev felt that he can safely tell his story. And he still did not know what the object was. Now, this is a somewhat complicated story that needs clarification. A version of it was published on various Western websites, and the date of the Afanasyev sighting is April of 1979. But that is impossible. He was still a pilot in the Soviet Air Force at the time. And I'll tell you more about his experiences later. He also attended the Moscow Aviation Institute between 1976 and 1980, the Aktubins branch, to become an aircraft manufacturing engineer. Russian websites state that he flew Soyuz 30 spacecraft. This is based on the program that aired on RAN TV. Now, the program was a British documentary made in 2003. I couldn't find it to view, just some references to it in Russian. However, the internet has an old program titled Sightings that contains cosmonaut Afanasyev interview. He doesn't state the date of the orbital sighting. I doubt that Viktor Afanasyev, a well-respected space explorer and scientist, would intentionally deceive his interviewers. The translation was incorrect in my opinion. The year of the sighting is most likely 1999, not 1979. You see, in the year of 1999, pilot cosmonaut of the USSR number 70, Viktor Afanasyev, had participated in a 188-day space flight aboard the Soyuz TM transport vehicle and the Mir orbital station from February 20 to August 28, 1999. Soyuz TM-29 was a Russian manned spacecraft launched from the Baikonur Cosmodrome aboard the Soyuz rocket. Soyuz TM-29 docked with Mir on February 22. Afanasyev was the only Russian cosmonaut aboard because, two seats for the crew had been sold to France and Slovakia. The other cosmonauts were Jean-Pierre Hagnier and Ivan Bella. Thus, if there was any sighting aboard Soyuz TM-29, not Soyuz 30, it would have been in the month of February, arrival or August departure, and would be aboard the same spacecraft. Because in April, the cosmonauts were aboard Mir station. From 1977 to 1988, Viktor Afanasyev served as a test pilot and senior test pilot at the State Flight Testing Center, named after Valery Chkalov, who was a famous Soviet pilot. Also, in the years 1985-1987, he was a Buran Soviet space shuttle test pilot. He was fortunate not to perish or die, as did most others associated with the Doom project. You see, experienced Soviet test pilots were selected to train for the manned missions using Buran. And Afanasyev became a test cosmonaut in 1988. Total time Afanasyev spent in space, 555 days. So now I want to go to the year of 1985 and tell you about a very strange case. In 1959, a town was created in the barren semi-desert steppes, 292 kilometers north of the city of Astrakhan. Akhtubinsk is the name of the town that prides itself on being the home of the Russia's largest state flight testing center. Государственный летно-испытательный центр Министерства обороны имени Чкалова. In addition to the north of the city, there is the Groshevo or Vladimirovka military testing range. In my years of research of Soviet UFO phenomena, I have encountered a number of cases from that territory. Afanasyev was one of those who sort of had a UFO fight sighting while serving there. In November of 2005, Colonel, who was now retired, Alexander Akimenkov, was one of the speakers at the annual Russian UFO conference titled Zhigalovskiye Chteniye. The former test pilot presented a very detailed lecture about his experiences with UFO encounters during Soviet testing of new weapons in the Asian regions of the USSR. I've written about his experiences before in my books, and I hope to write more. In 1983, Akimenkov served in Akhtubinsk. The retired colonel recalled that UFOs had visited the testing center and the range so frequently that the pilots had an impression that aliens knew flight schedules better than Soviet military. He recollected the UFO sighting in the 1980s, when he flew missions with Viktor Afanasyev in the area. They were testing new missiles in January of that year, most likely 1985. The two of them were flying MiG-23 aircraft. The command post raised the target and the pilots were ready to intercept. There was a glitch and the target crashed down. The pilots were quite concerned because they were beyond the testing range and beyond the railroad. The snow-covered ground had a hole left by the target and there was a tractor nearby. But no people were around and the pilots calmed down. At that time, the duty officer from the command post reported that there was an object over them at the height of about 600 meters. In the eastern part of the sky, they noticed a moon of gigantic size. They didn't see any object. The duty officer was adamant that the object was there and it was ascending. The pilots were at the altitude of approximately 600 meters. So they began ascending slowly, too, to see what the object was. But they didn't see anything. The object was reported to depart in the eastward direction. They naturally tried to catch it, but did not have enough fuel. And most important, did not see whom they were chasing or what they were chasing. Akimenkov and Afanasyev stopped the chase and returned to the airfield. The source of the Kimenska's presentation at the Zhigalovskiye Chteniye is Mikhail Gerstein's online magazine UFO Navigator, dated December 2005. Mikhail Gerstein is probably the best UFO researcher in the former Soviet Union. And the other one is Vadim Chernobrov, whom I mentioned frequently in my videos. But back to Afanasyev. Not long ago, Viktor Afanasyev mentioned something very curious and fascinating. The outer space has its own smell, according to the Russian cosmonaut. He and his colleagues detected unmatched star scent that permeated the space module. This scent is indestructible. Even back home, when he retrieves items that were in the orbit, he still smells it. But the spacesuits used by spacewalks smell differently. There is no Earth terrestrial comparison or equivalent to that scent. It just smells like space. The source for this story is the March 28, 2013 article Чем пахнет космос? Or what does this space smell like? Who knows what awaits us as we explore the outer space? We have not wandered too far from the embrace of our planet, but have already encountered wonders that we're not able as yet to explain. I guess smell is one of them. Now I want to talk about Viktor Gorbatko. Viktor Gorbatko, a Soviet cosmonaut, major general, and twice awarded Hero of the Soviet Union honor, was one of the original 20 cosmonauts selected for space flights. few are alive today. He has flown over 39 days on 3 space flights. In 1969, Gorbatko made his first flight aboard Soyuz 9. In 1980, Viktor Gorbatko flew aboard an international mission. Later, he was a professor at the Air Force Engineering Academy in Moscow. In the interview conducted by a Russian newspaper Nomer Odin, April 12, 2012 issue, he was asked, among other things, about intelligent life on other planets, about UFOs and flying saucers. Viktor Gorbatko responded that there are some unexplained phenomena out there. He recalled an incident during his flight aboard the Soyuz 24 mission. Because Gorbatko did not provide several details about the Soviet space program and its secret missions, I did some research and filled in the gaps. His flight engineer during that mission was cosmonaut Yuri Glaskov, a Soviet Air Force officer. Later in life, Glaskov held the rank of Major General in the Russian Air Force. Soyuz 24, and by the way, the spacecraft was Soyuz 7KT, so-called space station ferry. This was a 1977 mission to the Salyut 5 space station, the third and final mission to the station, and manned by the last purely military crew for the Soviet space flight. The mission ended on February 25, 1977. Cosmonaut Yuri Glaskov passed away in 2008. Both cosmonauts were engaged in routine work while in orbit, when they were shaken by a very strong blow. The blow was so powerful that they immediately found themselves lodged next to the life support systems. Glaskov was on the air supplies assembly and Gorbatko at the control panel. After they returned to Earth, Gorbatko reported the incident to Vladimir Chelomey. This was a Soviet mechanic scientist, aviation and missile engineer, designer of the Proton rockets. Chelomey competed with Sergei Korolev to get the Soviet cosmonauts on the surface of the moon. Although it was never used to send cosmonauts to the moon, as Chelomey had planned, the Proton has been widely used to launch Soviet satellites, as well as all Soviet and Russian space stations and module, including two of the first three components of the International Space Station. The USSR's moon program was divided among three competing design groups, led by Korolev, Mikhail Yangel, Valentin Glushko, and Vladimir Chelomey. Gorbatko trained for such a mission, but it never took place. Now, after Chelomey heard Gorbatko's report, he advised the cosmonaut to be quiet about the incident and not to report it to the State Commission on Piloted Flights. Gorbatko never found out what hit his spaceship. Was it a meteorite? He didn't know why the meteorite did not pierce the outer skin of the spaceship and did not damage it. Viktor Gorbatko has been proud that he knew Yuri Gagarin, Yuri Glaskov, Sergei Korolev, Vladimir Chelomey, that he was one of those who opened the way into outer space. And of course, as we enter more and more into the outer space, we'll encounter more and more fascinating phenomena. And I'll tell you more in the future about Russian space program and the strange objects that cosmonauts observe in the space. Thank you.